गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग अरिफ। टुडे इज अवर सेशन रिगार्डिंग प्रोडक्शन इकोनॉमिक्स एंड इट्स इम्पोर्टेंस एंड डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट रिलेटेड टू प्रोडक्शन इकोनॉमिक्स, डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स, डिफरेंट प्रोडक्शन फैक्टर्स एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स गोइंग टू डिस्कस बाय मिस्टर अरिफ मुल्ला। इज ए पीएचडी स्कॉलर फ्रॉम रॉबर्ट लॉ एग्रीकल्चर कॉलेज। Okay. You can share your screen. Yes, sir. Continue.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Good morning to all. Myself, MRF, Department of Agriculture Economics. Today, I am discussing about the basics, fundamental production economics. Why? Because means production economics play key role in both marketing structure. One concept is there, marketing structure. In marketing structure, we are discussing about what is the optimal output for the entrepreneur, as well as what is the profitable output for the entrepreneur. There is some small difference between the optimal output and economical output and profitable output points. So we are focusing on production economics as well as the marketing aspects also. Okay, before going to the this concept, we are know the basics laws. What is the law of returns and return to scale? Okay, law of returns is a short-term production process. Return to scales explain long run. Okay, law of returns explains the for example, inputs are available are larger in nature. Okay, number of inputs are available, all inputs are unable to change at a time, only few inputs are changing is possible. For example, here is there seed, fertilizers, labor availability is there. Okay, seed, fertilizers, labor. Here, seed, fertilizers, labors keeps, I am keeping constant for the situation 5. Situation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I am taking 5 situation. For example, seed rate is 25. Fertilizer dosage is 50. Number of labors utilization is 8 members. Okay, situation 1. What is the output quantity? In situation 2, seed rate is 25. Fertilizer dosage is 50. And the number of labor employed for the production process is 9 members. Okay, I am changing only labor, number of labors factor, inputs variation takes place, single factors. Okay, law of returns will be helpful. Okay, law of returns will be comes into operation, only single input variation is possible, remaining all inputs are kept as a constant. That is the law of returns basic concept. Concept behind the law of returns. Okay, situation 3 and 4, all these points I am seed rate is keep as a constant, I am fertilizer dosage also keep as constant, I am changing, variation will be takes place as a labor employed in the process. When labor is increases, output is also increasing rate or decreasing rate, what is the position of the output situation? We are considering the output, inputs is increases, what is the output position? This is the law of returns explained. When changes in the single input, output is in increasing rate or a decreasing rate or constant. For example, 25, 50, 8 is there. For output is taken as the or 20. When labor is employed to 9 members, that output is increased to 25. Same as the 25, 50, 10. That time our output is increased to 35. And then going on increasing 11, our output is increases to 55. And then increases to 95. Here is there. Output is increases with the increasing rate. 20, 25. Just to 5. Output increases 5 units. 25 to 35. It is 10 units improvement in the output. Same as the 35 to 55. The output increases 20 units. From 55 to 95, the output is increases 40 units. Okay. The output, single input increases. The output also increases with increasing rate. Okay, same as for example, there is some constant rate also is there. labor is there. Our output is 20 and then become 30 and 40 and 50 and 60 like that. So this is called as the output is increases with the constant rate. Okay. Law of returns also further divided into increasing, decreasing, constant. Okay. Increasing returns, decreasing returns and constant returns. This is a constant returns, constant rate of improvement in the output. When labor is increases, when labor increases, the output also increases with the constant rate. Okay. When sometimes it is a decreasing rate also. For example, here is the starting our output is 60 units, followed by our output is 100 units, and followed by our output is 130, and followed by our output is 135, and followed by our output is 136. This is the 138 taken as a 138. This is 130. This is 100. Okay, our output is going on increases. Okay, our output is going on increases, but here the rate of change is 60 to 100. The output variation is 40 units. Okay, here is 30 units. Here variation is 8 units. Here variation is just 1 unit. 138 to 139. Just 1 unit variation is there. Okay, 60. 38 to 1 unit. Here is the, our output is increases but in decreasing rate. Okay, in competitive exams also they are asking is there. For example, improvement in the input, but the output is increases but below to the previous output. That is considered as a decreasing in output. Okay, input level increases, the output level is also increases, but it is lesser than the previous change. This is the change. This is the change. Here, change in the output is 60 units. Change in the output is 30 units. The change in output is lesser than the previous change. Okay. Remember here, I am showing in empirical formula. Change in output. Change in output is lesser than change in succeeding output. Okay. I am taking as a Y1. And Y2 and Y3. Okay, the change between the Y2 and Y3, okay, is more than the, this one. Here change is 30 units. Here change is 60 units. So the change is, this change is lesser than the previous units of the, that is comes under decreasing returns. Okay, the answer is decreasing returns. The change in the output is lesser than the previous change in the output. It is known as the decreasing returns. Change in the input is same change in the output level at the every point. It is called as a constant returns. Okay, change in Y2 is same as the change in Y1. Okay, the change in output level is previous successor and previous one. All this change is 10 units, 10 units, 10 units. That is constant returns. Okay, this is the law of returns. Law of returns explains number of inputs availability is more, but we are changing the single input, variation in the single inputs. What is the output position? We are identify the output position, increasing, constant, decreasing. That is law of returns. Return to scales explains. Return to scales comes into operation means we are changing the all available inputs. Okay. Here is there. We are focusing on return to scale. Return to scale means it is study about the simultaneous at the same proportion. Seed, fertilizers, labors, availability is there. 10 units, 20 units, 4 units. Okay. We are changing all available inputs. 10, 24. Here is 20, 45 units. Change in the all inputs at the simultaneous, at a same time, same proportion. 10 to 20. Okay. 20 to 30. 30 to 40. The change is 10 units, 10 units, and 10 units. Okay. Here is the fertilizer changes also takes place. The change at the same time, simultaneous changes 20. Here is 20 and the proportionate change is 20. Okay. Return to scale. The key most important point in the return to scale is the keyword is change in inputs takes place simultaneously with the same proportion. Seed rate variation done with the 10 units. upcoming variations also compulsory takes place by 10 units, 10 units, 10 units, 10 units. Okay. Here is 20 units, 20 units, 20 units. The labor variation, change in the labor input is done by with the single input variation, one unit, one unit, one unit, one unit. So this is the variations. Okay. All are same. Here is increasing, constant, decreasing output variation. Same as the return to scale also comes into operation. Increasing, constant, decreasing returns. Okay. But small change in the law of returns and return to scale is the proportionate change. Okay. Here we are keeping seed and fertilizers constant. We are changing, turning the variation in the single input. Okay. For example, the availability of inputs are three. Among the three, two are kept as a constant inputs. One is taken as a variable input. Okay. But in return to scale, all inputs are variable in nature. Okay. All variables are, all inputs are varying in nature. Variation is possible. All inputs variation is possible in long run production process. That is comes under return to scale. Okay. All inputs are variation is possible, comes under return to scale. Okay. In return to scale also, we are discussing about increasing return to scale, constant return to scale, decreasing return to scale based upon the output variation. The output variation is always constant. The change in the output is, okay, this is the Y1 and Y2. The output variation is done with the same units, 10 units, 10 units, 10 units. That is a constant return to scale. When variation is done with the increasing rate, okay, the variation is the change between Y2 and Y1. This is a Y2, this is a Y1. Y2 minus Y1, the change is 60 and then 70, 80 and 90. Like that, the variation is going on increasing. That is increasing return to scale. And then decreasing in nature, 60, okay, 60, 50, 40, 30. Like that, it is going on decreasing. This is decreasing return to scale. This is the change in output. Okay. The change in output variation is going on decreasing. It is decreasing return to scale. And then where we are applying marginal returns, marginal cost, marginal value products, marginal input cost. Okay. This concept is clear? Law of returns and return to scale?
Sir, in law of returns, please explain the graphs of increasing returns and decreasing returns.
Okay, in the graphical format. In graphical formats, I will explain in upcoming point. Here is there. This is a TPP, APP, MPP. How is increases? How is decreases? Okay.
Okay.
Remember, in graphical format also, here is there. This is on y-axis, this is on x-axis. Okay. Law of returns is same as this. Three stages of production functions. Okay. Three stages of the production functions is also a law of returns. Why? Because means on x-axis we are taking the input, on y-axis we are taking the output point. Okay, here is single input is variation is done 3, 4, 5. Here is the output point. Output is increases or decreasing in rate. Okay, for example, input is increases at the increasing rate. Our graph is going on increases. This is the one unit. Okay, the variation is larger in position. 10 units, 20, 30, 40. Okay, one unit, two units, three. This is the labor improvement is there. Input on x-axis, remember this also. X-axis consists of independent variables. Y-axis consists of dependent variables. Output depends on variation in the inputs points. Okay, inputs variation is done. Output also variation is takes place. How much changes takes place? That is also increases. Okay, this is the increasing returns. So, this is the increasing returns. Remember here, small variation in the input gives larger variation in the output. So because output increases with the larger variation, so increasing returns will be takes place, same as the decreasing return to scale. I am taking this color. Our decreasing return to scale also, our line started from this point, but it takes place this type of shape. Why? Because means in previous examples also, I am taking as the 138 and 139. It is taken as a 138 and 139. It one more upper point is 130. The variation is 8 units and the variation is the 1 unit. Okay, so larger variation in the output gives smaller variation in the output. Okay, this is the larger variation in the input decreasing. The output is smaller variation in the output. Okay, the variation in the output is less, just 1 unit is takes place. So remember this one when I am drawing once again. Okay, remember this is y-axis, this is x-axis. Here we are taking inputs, on y-axis we are taking the output. Okay, when increasing returns, law of returns operate in increasing returns format, this is our line. Okay, small change in the inputs, this is the small variations in the input gives larger variation in the output. Okay, increasing output, output is increases in larger proportion. Okay, it is clear. And then when decreasing return to scale is operated, the line is also started from the origin and going on, it is she takes place this much. Okay, this is backward, this is downward shaping. Same at the same output level, the output input usage is this much. Okay, this is the output point. This is a small change in the output. Our input variation is larger. Larger output variations gives lesser output variation. The output is decreases. Input going on increases. The output variation is less. Okay, this is the decreasing. This is the increasing. Constant means same proportion. This is taken as a straight line. Okay. This is taken as a straight line because same proportion will be takes place. Same proportion. Output and out input. Which proportion input is increases? That is the same proportion will be increases in the output. Okay. Remember here that 1, 2, 3, 4. Input increases with the proportionate changes 1 and 1, 1. The output is increases 10, 20, 30. Okay. Some people think that the proportionate change is 1, 1, 1. Why? Because our output is increases to 10, 11, 12, 13. The same proportionate means here is the change is 10. Here is also the proportionate change is 10. The units of proportionate change is same. 10 units, 10 units, 10 units. Don't compare this proportion with output proportion. Okay. That time we are getting confusion in return to scale and law of returns also. Okay. The proportionate change in input is 1 input proportionate change, input, okay, the output proportionate change is also same. This is the proportionate change in the output is 10, 10 and it becomes 40. It is also 10 units proportionate change. Okay, I'm saying once again, take clear about the statements. Input change is the proportionate input change is constant 1, 1, 1. The output proportionate change is also same. Same proportionate change takes place between input and output. This is the output. This is the input. Okay. Here is input 1. The output is changes. Here I am taking as a 1, 2, 3. Here output points taken as a 10, 20 and 30. It is clear? Hello?
Oh, okay. Sir, in decreasing returns, are you concave, sir?
This is backward. Okay, we are not exactly saying downward sloping. This is upward sloping. We cannot proportionate concave or concave. It is not accurate statements. Okay, this our curve is this type. This is say has the concave. Okay, this is convex shape. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. And then I am going to the profitability concept. What is marginal revenue, marginal cost, marginal value product, marginal input cost? Okay. Here, marginal revenue. Marginal revenue means additional income earned from usage of the additional unit of output. Okay, this is the marginal revenue is the output concept. Marginal cost is also a output concept. Remember the statement is additional income or additional revenue come earned from production of additional unit of output. Additional cost incurred to production of additional unit of output. Additional cost incurred for the additional production of output. Okay, this is related to the additional production of output, additional production of output. Okay, marginal value product is additional income received from production using of the additional input. Additional returns comes from the usage of additional input. Additional cost incurred to usage of additional input, that is the marginal input cost, marginal revenue. Okay, here is there, I am one more is there. Additional incomes comes from the additional output. Additional cost gained by additional output, additional production. Additional income comes from the usage of additional inputs. Additional cost earned or caused, additional cost caused by additional usage of the input. Okay, this is the definition of marginal input cost. Okay, what is the definition of marginal revenue, marginal cost, marginal value product, marginal input cost? This competitive exams also definitions are most important. Okay, take care. What is marginal revenue? Additional income comes from additional output production, known as, in simple bits, additional incomes comes from the additional output. It is known as the MR, MC, MVP, MIC. That time we are selecting the MR. Okay, additional cost, simple one word is changes. Here is income or returns, here is cost. Same statement, same bit. Additional cost is caused for the production of additional output. Okay, income is given, that time we are selecting the revenue, marginal revenue. When additional cost is given, we are selecting the marginal cost. Okay, same as the additional income, here is the input is changes. Additional input uses for the additional income, that time comes under marginal value product. Remember here, marginal value product is also pronounced as a marginal factor cost. Most of times, sometimes they given as a MFC. Okay, marginal factor cost. Some options they are given as the marginal input cost. Okay, sorry, here is there marginal input cost, marginal factor cost. Okay, marginal value product is, okay, marginal value product is different. Marginal input cost is also pronounced as the marginal factor cost. Remember it. Okay, not here, not MVP. Okay, marginal value product is separate. Marginal input cost is also pronounced as marginal factor cost. Marginal input cost is also known as the marginal factor cost. Okay, take care here. I'm once again explaining. Marginal value product is additional income, additional input. Marginal input cost or marginal factor cost means additional cost for the usage of additional input. Okay, this is marginal cost. One more concept is the elasticity of production. Same as the elasticity of demand, elasticity of supply, we are also discussing about elasticity of production. Elasticity of production explains about the responsiveness of the input and output. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the input level. Okay, these are the input. I am taking as a X is our input, Y is the output. Responsiveness of the input increases, output is increases in the 10, 20, 30 and 40. Okay, and one more is there. This is the situation A, situation B also is there. It is increases in the form of 100 and then 150 and then 200 and then 500. Elasticity of production explains responsiveness between input and output. Output is increases in one unit, 1, 2, 3, 4. Output is also increases same proportion, 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay. Otherwise it is, how is going on? It's different proportion, 100, 150, 200, and then the variation is 300. Suddenly the output production is increases by the 300 units. Okay. How the responsiveness, output is increases, output is also increases. What is its response? it is constantly increases or going on constantly increases up to the certain point, up to the input level 3. Further use of the fourth unit of the input, the sudden improvement in the output will be takes place. It's the elasticity of production. Check the responsiveness. Okay, how much elasticity takes place? The stretching between input increases and output increases. What is the stretching between and input and output? Okay, it is explaining responsiveness between input and output. Okay, remember this points. Elasticity of production, it is a responsiveness of the input and output. One more bit is there. Technical and mathematical relationship between and input and output represented by. Anyone known this answer for this? Mathematical relationship between an input output is known as? Production function. Okay, mathematical and technical relationship between input and output is known as a production function. Responsiveness between an input and output is known as the elasticity of production. Remember the key points are most important in economics. Remember this, all these points. Okay, I'm once again explaining responsiveness between input and output, the stress between input and output. Okay, output going on increases constantly and sudden stress stretching takes place between output. Okay, how the response will be takes place, the responsiveness between an input and output is elasticity of production. Okay, this is the symbol for the elasticity of production. P means elasticity of production. Sometimes in options given as a E and subscription S. This is the elasticity of supply. This is the elasticity of demand. Compulsory, you are selecting the, this is EP, elasticity of production is responsiveness between an input and output. This is the supply, elasticity between price and supply. How much price is increases, how much supply is increases, the responsiveness between price and supply. Okay, elasticity of demand, the prices decreases, which extent demand will be stretched, increase in the demand. Okay, which extent it is increases, elasticity of demand, elasticity of supply, elasticity of production. It is the responsiveness between input and output. Input is increases, same manner the output stretching also is takes place or not, extent of output increases or not, supply, demand, production. Okay, in place of responsiveness we are keeping as a mathematical relationship or technical relationship between an input and output, it known as the production function. Production function, remember this is the, in economics they are touching the basic concept. In previous question papers also questions focused on the basic concept, what is production functions, product, production. Okay, product is different, production is separate, production function is different. Okay, production function is the relationship between and input and output. Production means it is a simple production function is relationship between an input output. When we are removing this word function, production means simply production is the transformation of input into output, the process. Production is a process, the process by which inputs are converted into output, it is known as a production. Okay, production function is a relationship between input output. Production is a process, the process by which inputs are converted into output, it is known as a production. Product, what is product? Further I am removing these three alphabets. Product, what is product? Product means end product of the result of the production process. End result of the production process is the product. What we are getting, end of the production process is a product. End product of the production process is known as a product. Okay, it is clear. Production function, production and product. And next one is the formulas. What is the formula for the marginal revenue? What is the formula for the marginal cost? What is the formula for the marginal value product and marginal input cost? Okay, I am simply keep as the marginal revenue. Here is a PY. This means this is the price of the output. PX, this is the price of the input. Okay. PY represent price of the output. PX is the price of the input. Okay. Why I am keeping this simply formula for the marginal revenue. Marginal revenue is same equal to the price of the output means I am writing here is it. Take care. I am explaining this why, how to we are getting marginal revenue same as the price of the output. Okay. Why our marginal cost is not equal to the price of the input. Okay. I am explaining how to we are getting this price of the whole. Why? The basic concept is, I am previously also said that marginal revenue, formula for the marginal revenue is income, additional output. Okay. Additional income is the change. Additional means change. Change in the total returns. Okay. Income means returns. Change in the total returns divided by change in the output. Okay. This is the change in the output. This is our basics definition of the marginal returns. I am taking another slide. Okay. Remember, I am closing this. I am keeping this slide blank. Please don't confuse. I am getting this point from these definitions. How marginal revenue is equal to the price of the output. Okay. From the definition point of view, additional income, additional output. I am taking just to this two definition, additional income, additional output. Okay. Additional income means change in the total returns. Additional income means change in the total returns. Ratio between the change in total returns to the change in output. Okay. And then I am moving forward to further elaborated, expanding this formula. Change in total returns means change in output divided by, this is the change in output. Okay. Formula for the total returns is change in output and price of the output. Okay. Total returns, formula for the total returns is change in output multiplied with the price of the output. Okay. Is equal to the our change in total returns. Okay. Formula for the total returns is price, market price of the output into quantity of the output. I am explaining about the change. So compulsory here also we are taking the change in output. Simple formula for the total returns is price, market price of the output multiplied with the quantity of the output. Quantity of the output, price of the output. Here we are discussing about change in returns. So I am also taken as a change in output. Okay. Output change, quantity of the output change. So change in Y multiplied with the price of the Y and then price of the Y. I am canceling these two things. Okay. Change in Y is canceled and change in Y is canceled. Remaining one is price of the Y. So our marginal revenue is also equal to the price of the output. Okay. Price of the output. It is clear. MR, marginal revenue, is also equal to the price of the output. Same as the marginal cost. Why marginal cost is not equal to the price of the input? Why? Because means I am saying that here is a change in total cost. Why? Because means change in cost by change in output. In previous table also I am said that additional cost and additional output, same as additional output is change in Y, additional cost is change in total cost, and further expanding this formula as the change in input level, additional cost, change in X multiplied with the price of the input divided by change in the output. Okay. Formula for the marginal physical product. Okay, here is the total cost. Formula for the total cost is price of the input multiplied with the quantity of the output. This is the quantity of input. This is the price of the input. Total cost is how we are getting total cost. Quantity of input multiplied with the price of the input. Some another formula is that total cost is also considered as the total fixed cost plus total variable cost. Okay. formula for the total cost is total fixed cost plus total variable cost. Remember this cost concept also is there. In my demo class, I will explain all these things. What is total cost, total fixed cost, total variable cost. Okay. In short run only, we are experiencing fixed cost and variable cost. In long run process, all are variable nature. Okay. Short run only, we are differentiating the inputs into fixed inputs and variable inputs. In long run, all are same. All are variable nature. Variation is possible. So we cannot differentiate into fixed cost and variable cost. Okay. Total cost is the summation of total fixed cost and total variable cost. In another formula is there. Total cost is the multiplication of quantity of input with the market price of the input, Px, and the quantity of input. Okay. This is the change in X multiplied with the price of the input. I am further separating this two one. Change in X by change in Y. Change in X by change in Y represents marginal physical product. Marginal physical product. Formula for the marginal physical product is change in output by change in input. This is the marginal physical product. Formula for the marginal physical product. But what will be happen? This is reverse in position. Change in X by change in Y. So I am removing this one, change in X by change in Y, and keeping as the MPP. Okay. This is reverse. MPP is equal to change in Y by changing in X. 1 by marginal physical product. 1 by MPP is equal to change in X by change in Y. Okay. A formula for the MPP is change in Y by change in X. When X is going to the upper side, Y becomes lower side. Change in X by change in Y. That time our MPP is 1 by MPP. So change in X by change in Y is equal to 1 by MPP. Price of X is multiplied with the 1 by MPP. Okay. That time our formula is considered as the MC is also equal to price of the input and divided by marginal physical product. Okay. It is clear. Marginal revenue is equal to the price of the output. Okay. Marginal cost is equal to the ratio between the input price and marginal physical product. Okay. Ratio between the input price and marginal physical product represents marginal cost. The ratio between input price and MPP represents marginal cost. Okay. It is clear. Is there price of the X multiplied with the MPP. The ratio between input price and marginal physical products represents marginal cost. Okay. The multiplication between the price of the output and MPP represents marginal value product. How it is coming as the same as the additional income. Additional income means change in output multiplied with the price of the output. Okay. Divided by additional input. This is the change in input. Change in X. Change in Y by change in X represents marginal physical product. Okay. And then remaining portion is price of the output. So this is one. Okay. Additional income. Additional input. This is the formula. How we are getting marginal value product is also equal to the multiplication between price of the output and marginal physical product. Okay. And then marginal input cost. Additional cost means change in input and price of the input divided by change in the input. Change in the input. Okay. Here is change in X. Change in is crossed. And remaining one is the price of the X. Okay. This is the price of the X. Price of the input is equal to the marginal input cost. Price of the output is equal to the marginal revenue. Okay. How we are getting marginal cost means it is a ratio between price of the input and marginal physical product. Okay. How we are getting marginal value product? We are multiplying the marginal physical product with the price of the output, and then we are getting the marginal value product. Okay. In the competitive exams, they wanted to give some difficult bits. That time they are giving simply given as the calculation format. Simply, they are giving as the price of the input is 20 rupees. Price of the output is 10 rupees. And what is the MPP is also given as the MPP is 50. The MPP is 50. What is the marginal value product? And then what is the marginal value product is we are multiplying MPP into price of the output. 50 into 10. 500 rupees is the marginal value product. What is the marginal cost? That time we are dividing is 20 divided by 50, and then we are getting the marginal cost. Okay, this in competitive exams also important as the MPP, price of X, price of Y is given, and I calculate the marginal cost and calculate the marginal value product. That time we are going to this formulas, and also they are saying that what is the marginal revenue. That time simply say that what is our price of the output is same is equal to the marginal revenue. What is the marginal input cost? Calculate the marginal input cost based on this MPP, PX, PY. That time simply our marginal cost is same equal to the price of the input. 20 rupees is our marginal cost. Okay. It is clear how to calculate marginal revenue, marginal cost, marginal value product, and marginal input cost.
Marginal input cost is equal to price of input, no sir?
Input. Yes, yes.
Okay, sir.
How it is also equal means change in total cost means change in input quantity multiplied into price with the price of the input divided by
change in input.
Okay, this is the definition. What is the definition of marginal input cost? Is additional cost caused because of usage of the additional input. This is our marginal input cost definition. So as I am calculating the marginal input cost from this formula, additional cost, additional input. So change in input quantity multiplied with the price of input by change in input. This X is cancelled, this X is cancelled. Remaining is the price of the X. Okay. So marginal input cost is same as equal to the price of the input. Okay.
If cost comes, you should take inputs. If it is returns, then you should take the output, no sir?
Yes, yes, returns. Marginal returns. We are taking the price of the output.
Output. If it is cost, then you should take the input.
Input price.
Okay. Input price remember, into change in input.
Input. For a simple technical point of view, MC and MR. Here is there. Out is there. Here 3 is there. We are taking as a 2. Here is there. Out. Is there marginal revenue? 2. Okay. Input is there. In 2. That time we are taking the marginal value product. Marginal input cost. Some people are confusing. We are taking at the bottom input or output. Change in input or change in output. So simply remember. MR. That time we are in bottom taking as the output. Okay. We are discussing in terms of output. MR and MC. MR, MC. These are related to the output. 2, 3. Here is 3 is there. You are taking 2. Marginal value product, marginal input cost. Input in 2. Okay. Input. MVP, MIC related to the input. MR, MC related to the output. Okay. For the key point of it. Some people are confusing. MVP. It is related to input or output. Here is 3. Here is 2. So it is comes to the input. Okay. Input is clear. MVP. Value product. Value product of the input. So we are considering the MPP multiplied with the price of the output. Okay. Like that. These are the how to identify. We are going to the input point or output point. MVP, MIC. Elasticity of production is also the same as the elasticity of demand. The percentage change in the output by percentage change in the input. Okay. The percentage change in the output by percentage change in the input. Remember, change in the Y2 minus Y1 divided by actual input. Percentage change in the output by percentage change in the input. X2 minus X1 divided by actual input. Okay. Y2 minus Y1, I am simply taken as the change in Y. Okay. Change in Y divided by Y1, I am taking as a simply Y. Okay. X2 minus X1, I am written as the change in X divided by x1 as taken as a same x. Okay, percentage, percentage means into 100. Okay, into 100 percentage we are calculating. That time we are multiplying with the 100 100 100. Okay, upper side and bottom side 100 is there. Simply I am eliminating this 100, this 100. So that time my formula is change in y by y, change in x by x. Okay, I am keeping this bottom into upper side as the, at that situation my formula is written as the change in x by x becomes x by change in x. Okay, I am combining all these two things. This is one, this is another one. When change in x by x going to the upper set, it becomes multiplication. Okay, that time it becomes change in y by y multiplied with the x by change in x. Okay, x becomes bottom, simple x becomes upper set. Okay, change in y by y, x by change in x. Okay, further I am written this formula as a change in y by change in x. Okay, I am sending this into this bracket and then this x keeps into this one. Okay, change in y by change in x in bracket I am taken as a x divided by y. Okay, in brackets x and y this side and change in x comes this side. Okay, change in y by change in x represents marginal physical product. Marginal physical product, formula for the marginal physical product is change in y by change in x. Okay, same as the ratio between output by input represents average physical product. What is the formula for the average physical product? Is it is the ratio between the output by input. Okay, but in our formula it is a ratio between the input by output, that becomes 1 by APP. APP is the y by x. When 1 by APP becomes x by y, ratio between input and output represents 1 by average physical product. Okay, so change in y by change in x is marginal physical product. Ratio between the input and output is represent 1 by MPP. Okay, finally I am this is a APP, average physical product. Change in output by change in input, marginal physical product. Ratio between the input by output is 1 by average physical product. This is the APP, average physical product. Okay, I am multiplying these two things, that becomes MPP by APP. Okay, this is the formula for the elasticity of production. Okay, percentage change in the, I am once again explaining from the starting point of view I am taking. Okay, what is elasticity of production? Elasticity of production means the percentage change in the output. Okay, the percentage change in the output by percentage change in the input. Okay, I am expanding this formula as the change in y by change in x into 100. Why? Because means percentage is taken, so into 100 into 100. Upper side, bottom side, the 100 is taken. I am cancelling this 100, 100. Then only I am getting change in y by y into change in x by x. Remember, 2, 1, 1, I am irrespective of giving the specific numbers. First unit of output, second unit of output, I am simply enter this output as taken as a y. Okay? I am removing this number of name of the output. One, first output, second output. Simply, I am removing this numbering of the output. So, I am taken as a change in output by actual output. Okay, y by 1. Same as a first input, second input by first input. I am removing this numbering, naming of the input as a change in x by actual quantity of the input. Okay, and then after getting these values, I am further sending this change in x by x into upper side. Okay, that time my change in x by x becomes x by change in x. Okay, I am written as here change in y by actual y, x by change in x. Okay, and then further I am doing cross section. This not cross section, multiplying this bracket. I am sending out of this bracket and bringing actual quantity of output into my bracket. Okay, change in y by y, actual quantity of x by change in x. Okay, change in x within the brackets sent to the out of the brackets. Okay, actual quantity of output brings into the within the brackets. Okay, that time change in y by change in x. Okay, change in y by change in x, and then within the brackets actual quantity of input by actual quantity of output. Okay, the ratio between the change in output by change in input is, the formula for the change in output by change in input is marginal physical product, same as the within the brackets. The ratio between the input by output represents 1 by APP. Okay, formula for the average physical product is ratio between the output by input. Okay, formula for the APP is the output by input. When I am taking the 1 by APP, that time I am, this is also changing. X by Y. X by Y is equal to the 1 by APP. Okay, remember. So, finally, elasticity of production becomes ratio between the marginal physical product and average physical product. It is clear? Okay, elasticity of production is also equal to the ratio between marginal physical product and average physical product. We are elaborating from this formula, percentage change in output by percentage change in the input. Okay, now I am explaining about the three stages of production functions. Okay, this is the input, this is the output. Okay, actual output, total output is also equal to the total physical product. Total physical product is same as the actual output. Formula for the average physical product is ratio between the output and input. Formula for the marginal physical product is change in output by change in input. Okay, change in y by change in x. Okay, what and then increasing returns or constant returns or decreasing returns or negative returns. Okay, based upon the, some people say that based upon the elasticity we are seeing that increasing returns or decreasing returns or constant returns there. In tabular methods, remember these points. First of all, inputs and outputs. I am removing all these things. Okay, first of all, inputs is given, outputs is given. Output is same as the total physical product. Okay, actual output is same as the total physical product, and then we are, from this input and output, we are calculating the average physical product by ratio between the output and input. 2 divided by 1, 2. Ratio between 5 by 2 is equal to 2.5. Ratio between output and input. Okay, 9 by 3, 3, like that. Okay, and then we are calculating the marginal physical product. It is a change in output. This is the change between 9 and 5, 3, 5 and 2. This is the 3 unit change. Here is the 4, change is 4. Okay, this is the change, 3, 4. The change is 14 minus 9, 5. 19 minus 14, it is also further 5. Okay, change in output divided by change in input. Change in input is always 1 unit. Okay, 1. Here is also change in input is 1. Here is also 1. Okay, we are calculating the change in output by change in input is marginal physical product. Okay, based upon this changing values, we are calculating the marginal physical product. Okay, the change is 3 divided by 1 becomes 3. Okay, here is there 2 minus 0. I am first one is keeping as a blank. Why? Because means further there is no output. There is no change is there. Here is nothing is there. 0 minus something is nothing. So I am keeping as a blank. 2 minus 0 is becomes 2. 2 divided by 1 becomes 2. So I am here written as a the change is 2. Okay, so our marginal physical product also 2. 3 by 1 becomes 3. Okay, here is 4 divided by 1 becomes 4. This is a marginal physical product, ratio between the change in output by change in input. And then based upon the marginal physical product, increasing returns, constant returns, decreasing returns, and also negative returns. Okay. This is the tabular format. Marginal returns are increasing in nature and constant in nature, and then decreasing in returns and negative returns. Okay. Here is there. This is the values 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 1, 1, minus 2. At the 12th unit of input, our marginal returns are minus 2. At the 12th unit of our input, our marginal returns are minus 2. This red line represents marginal physical product. Okay. Red line represents marginal physical product. Green line represents average physical product. Here is it, 2.16. 2.16 is our average physical product. Okay. Here is there 26, 28, 29. Here is our total product. 28, 29, 29, 28. Okay. This is the TPP line. Green is APP, red line is MPP. Okay. Further, I would like to explain here three stages of production function. Condition for the first stage of the production function is when MPP equal to APP, where MPP is equal to the MPP. Here is the where MPP is equal to APP in between the points. 3 is there, 3.7 is there, 4 is there, 3 is there. In between the 6th unit and 7th units, MPP is equal to APP. Okay, in between the points, some points. Okay, that is called as the ending of the first stage, where our MPP becomes 0, TPP reaches maximum. Okay, this is the ending of the second stage. Three stages of the production function is also most important. Okay. Hello. This is TPP line, APP line, MPP line. When APP is equal to MPP, that is the ending of the first stage. When MPP becomes 0, and as well as the TPP value is maximum, that is also a ending of the second stage. Remaining is the third stage. In third stage, negative returns will be takes place. Okay. Here is also positive returns, but decreasing in nature. Here is positive MPP, but increasing in nature. Okay. Remember one point. One more point is there. When MPP is maximum at that point, TPP shows point of inflection. Okay. Here is there. Ending of the first stage, ending of the second stage. When marginal physical product is maximum at that point, TPP represents point of inflection. At that point, total physical product is increases but in a decreasing nature. Okay, in upcoming in next class I will explain all these things. What is the point of inflection? What is the shape of total physical curve? This is the first of all, it is convex and then it is concave initial stages and then converted into how it is convex. Okay. What is the point of inflection? In upcoming classes, I will explain all these things. Today class is concluded with these things. Okay. Now I am explaining what is MCMR, MVP, okay, elasticity of production. All these are important for the upcoming classes. Okay. In upcoming classes, I will explain all these things. Okay. What is MVP? It is increasing or decreasing? Okay, increasing or decreasing?
Increasing.
Average physical productivity increases, series decreases. In what ratio? TPP is positive or negative? I am explaining in upcoming classes. It takes 2 to 3 hours. Okay. Enter this single graph. I will explain with in detail in upcoming classes with this example also. Okay, why it is increases and decreases? In previous stages, it is concave and then converted into convex. How it is possible? What is the maximum point, minimum point? I will explain in upcoming classes. Okay, for reference books, it is also good for the production economics, farm management, and agriculture economics by Subba Reddy sir. Okay.
Students, please interact if any have any doubt. Yes, the students' side response is more important. You are our output. So interact wherever required. You can ask more than one time. These are the economic concepts. Generally, the something. Means not like common other concepts. We have to put some extra efforts in economic concepts. Even though all of this is not may not be required for your IBPS, but some of the concept is most important for your National Steel Corporation and other things. Okay, so just interact wherever you have any doubt. You can interact.
Excuse me, sir.
Sir, yes.
Sir, TPP initially concave and then convex and then concave, right?
Yes, Arif.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hello.
What?
Arif, you are muted, I think. Hello, Arif.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, visible.
Hello, sir.
Okay, okay. Next upcoming class, I will explain why it is concave and then why it is converted into cone. First of all, it is convex.
Concave.
Okay. I will explain upcoming classes. Okay. Increases with increasing rate.
Previous okay, any other coming. Question? Yes, Nagaraju.
Sir. Returns to scale graph explain. Yes, sir.
Both. Okay, okay. Return to scale of returns same. Both are.
Graph explain. Yes.
Return to scale graph, huh? Yeah. Arif,
here is one thing is there for the return to scale is we are discussing. For example, law of returns we are changing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 units like that. But in return to scale, first of all increases and then it keep as a constant and then decreasing return to scale appear because there is no fixed inputs are there. Inputs proportionate change. Change will be takes place in simultaneously. So we are experiencing increasing returns and constant returns and then decreasing returns for the especially for the long run production process our returns will be takes place this point okay and then increases and then up to the 2 to 4 constant returns and up to the 4th units it is decreases okay return to scale long run returns for example short run means we are dividing the total fixed cost and variable cost okay in long run we are not able to divide the and variable cost all cost is a cost that is a variable cost that is total cost total in long run production process total variable cost is equal to the total cost so here is there output is there input is there input and output so the proportionate change in the input all inputs is same so our line is going on increases and then shows decreases and this is merges decreases increasing constant decreasing okay This is the increasing constant decreasing returns for the return to scale. Sir, if possible, block the A42.
Just a minute, what happened?
Okay, sir, return to scale. Okay, graph for the return to scale is this. This is the type increasing constant and decreasing. Why? Because means we are experiencing all inputs, available inputs are variable nature. All are same proportionate changing will be takes place. So this type of graph will be takes place in the return to scale. Okay, in a short run process, there is a some are fixed, some are variable. So it is takes place. This type of shape will be takes place. Three various increasing, constant, decreasing will be takes place. Increasing, constant, decreasing will be takes place. Various shape. But here we are experiencing single line. Okay, increasing and constant. For example, we are drawing same things that time. Same diagram in three diagrams. This is the increasing. Another one is taken as a constant. Another one is taken as a decreasing returns. Okay, it is difficult to know the at which proportion is constant, at which proportion decreasing. So we are placing these three graphs into single graph. Okay, the proportionate change between inputs from second unit to fourth units, this is constant, and then going on from the point of this point, it is decreasing. So decreasing, the proportionate change between all variables from the fourth units, we are experiencing decreasing returns. In between 2 to 4, there is a constant. In between 1 to 2, increasing. Okay, this is initially increases, and second graph constant, third graph decreasing. So all our variables are, all inputs are same. So we are placing all these three lines into single graph. Okay, increasing, constant, decreasing. It is clear?
Okay, sir.
Are you getting this point?
Yes,
for
sir.
The law of returns, backward, downward, straight line. In return to scale also, straight line, and then constant and decreasing. But all inputs are same proportionate, simultaneous at the single point of time variation will be done. So we are putting this various graphs and a single graph. Increasing, constant, decreasing. We are saying that this much input proportionate simultaneous variation is constant. This is decreasing. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, any other? And regarding these polls, actually I thought that every weekend, every Sunday we have an exam, that's why I am not keeping polls. Inside of exam, if you want polls, then we will go for polls. Okay. Whatever, there also we are in exam also we are going to keep that for 10 questions on an hour, 10 questions related to each class in weekend. Along with exam is not possible, sir. So if you are, whatever the one, regarding one chapter, we are discussing 10 or 15 questions in poll. If again, we will, if you go to conduct exam, the mostly the same type of question from that class, then mostly the 10 to 15 questions only come. We'll think and discuss on that. But the question in exam. Okay, then if we'll plan for that from next class. Okay. Any other than that? Any doubt regarding class or regarding program? And I'm requesting you all to please, if any of your friends is preparing same type of exams or same type of these things, then please refer our academy. I think you are initially whatever from last 1 week you are with us, and I think we are satisfied as of now. Means whatever regarding quality. For your information, I tell you one thing. There is one academy called as An Academy, and one person is there in Ravi Bengal. Just if anybody of you is the member of that academy, just ask what is his education. I am not criticizing someone, but I am telling that you are almost all of you are completed your BSc graduation, or some of you is going to some of you going to complete your BSc agriculture, or some of you completed MSc agriculture also, and you are going to take classes from one non-agriculture graduate, non-agriculture people. It is, as per my knowledge, it is meaningless. I think you are the more knowledgeable about agriculture than non-agriculture peoples. Okay, somewhat farmers we keep away. I am not talking about farmers, but some B.Tech guy or some civil engineering guy going to teach you, or some zoology guy going to teach you agriculture, and you are paying for them. Okay. So please try to understand what's going in market. Not only this Ravi Bengal, just I was so many people is like that. Even your ACC fellow also is not agri graduate. What is that ACC? Okay. So I'm not here. My intention is not to criticize anyone, but the thing is, all of you have. All of you aware about what's going on in the market or in the outside. Otherwise, you can read from your books. If you don't, there is no need to go coaching. What is the need to learn? Means what they are doing. They are, as per my knowledge, what I get input from some of them is, they are before the class. They are preparing some PPTs or presentations, and they are boyheading or whatever that, and they are just putting on whatever the questions or what is on your head, and dumping the pages and pages of ANGRU or TNAU or ICAR material by changing their name. Okay, that up to you. Just I am telling that think about all those type of activities, and we'll meet again at 5:30. The topic is apiculture, another important topic for competitive exams, beneficial insects. Under that, apiculture, honeybee cultivation, honeybee production, honey production. We will discuss about all the aspects about apiculture at 5:30. Thank you. Any doubt, please? Okay.